Moving along, this is Adhikara of 3.3.18.19, Bhave and Akartrichakarke Sanyayam. Let us now take a look at the Sutram 3.3.24, which says, Shri Ni Bhuvo Nupasarge. Shri Ni Bhuvo Nupasarge. Vritti simply says, Shri Ni Bhu Ityete Bhyo Nupasarge Bhyo Ghanyasyat. So this rule applies to only three specific verbal roots, and they are Shri, which is Shriing Sevayam, in the Bhavadiganaha, or Ni, which is Ning Prapane, also from the Bhavadiganaha, and Bhusattayam, which of course is in the Bhavadiganaha. But there's one condition here. It says Anupasarge Bhyaha. So this apis ghai prescribed by this sutram may only be used if there is no upasarga in conjunction with these verbal roots. That is the condition here. So the apis ghai may be used following the verbal root Shri, Ni or Bhu, provided any one of these verbal roots is not in conjunction with the upasargaha, to denote either the sense of the verbal root as having attained to a completed state, which is of course Bhave from 3.3.18, or any karaka except the agent of the action, provided the word so derived is a proper name, that is Akartrichakarake Sanyayam. Now again, why do we need this sutram? Could we not have just used 3.3.18.19 itself? And the reason we know by now is that if this sutram were not to be there, in the case of Shri and Ni, because they end in Ivarnaha, the sutram Erach 3356 would have come and prescribed the affix Achcha. So this affix Ghing would not have been available had the sutram not been there. So this is an apavada for Achcha in the case of Shri and Ni. So this stops 3356 and puts back the Ghing. In the case of Vu, similar thing by the sutram Rudorap 3357, the affix Up is prescribed following a verbal root which ends in a dirgha rukaraha or a uvarnaha. Bhu ends in the uvarnaha. So therefore up would have come by 3357 rudorap, but now this sutram 3324 puts back the affix ghanya. So it stops rudorap in the case of this verbal root bhu. So the kashika says Ajaporapavadaha. Ajaporapavadaha. So this apis khai described by this sutram is apavadaha, exception to the apis ach in the case of Shri and Ni, which is prescribed by 3356, which would have been done by 3356, and to the apis up in the case of Bhu, which would have been done by 3357. Taking a simple example here, Bhavanam Bhavaha, derived from the verbal root Bhu. I put this word Bhavaha, we have used all the time. Basically, it's a completed act of being, a state of being, Bhavaha. Derivation is straightforward now. We take Bhu at the apis ghing by the sutram Shri Ni Bhuvo Nupasarge. The sutram prescribes apis ghing, and in the absence of this sutram, up would have come by 3357, but now we use apis ghing because there is no upasarga. This verbal root, anupasarge. There's no conjunction with the upasarga here. So we use the apis ghai, remove these letters, nyakarasit sanyaba halantyam, ghakarasit sanyaba lashakpat jite tasya lopaha, so we got bhu a. Now do the vridhyadesha for the ending ukaraha by acho nyiti, we get bhau a, and then acho yavayavaha, we get bhav a, and bhava gets the prajvadika sanyaba krit tadita samasascha. Pratama ekvachanam is bhavaha. So this is with the anuvritti of 3.3.8. Bhave. Now, this sutram says Anupasarge. So, if the verbal root has a conjunction with Upasargaha, is connected with Upasargaha, then we cannot use this sutram. So, Anupasarge tikim Prabhavaha. So, Prabhavaha, here we had Upasargaha pra in conjunction with the verbal root bhu. So, here we cannot use the affix ghai. We have to go and use the affix up by Rudo Rab 3357. So, we get the word Prabhavaha. As in the Bhagavad Gita, verse 8 of chapter 10, Aham Sarvasya Prabhavaha. So, Prabhavaha. Next time you chant that verse 8 in chapter 10, recall these two rules. First, of course, Bhave 3.3.18, then Akartichakarake Sanyayam 3.3.19, then Rudorap 3.3.57. And if the Upasarga Pra were not to be there, then we would use 3.3.24, Shri Ni Bho Upasarge. But here the Upasarga is there, so we have to use up by Rudorap. Now, what about this word, Prabhavaha? Katham prabhavo rajnyah iti. So how do we get this word? That is the glory or the power of the king. Don't we have upasarga here? It looks like we have one. We have pra. But what has really happened here is that Siddhanta Kaumudi clarifies the situation for us. He says that prakrishto bhavah iti pradi samasaha. So here what has happened is that actually the word bhavaha has been formed independently first, and then compounding has been done with para, meaning prakrishtaha. Prakrishtaha bhavaha. This is a special kind of a tatpurusha compound which we study later on when we study compound. Right now you may not be able to appreciate this example, but later on when we study tatpurusha compound, we study a special sutram 2218 kugati pradayaha. And that time we'll look at these pradi compounds like pracharyaha, pragataha acharyaha, pracharyaha. So what is really happening here is that pra is not connecting with bhu at all. It is actually in the meaning of prakrish. So since there is no upasarga connection with bhu, this sutram 3324 does apply. And we first form bhavaha and then compound it as prakrishto bhavaha, prabhavaha. So there is no violation of 3324 here.